This is great because if you start typing tourbillon watches in on any search engine, the suggested type will just take off. Tourbillon watches are a huge subject among enthusiasts, and it seems like you can get one from almost anybody today, right down to Memorigen and their sub $1,000 Chinese-made tourbillon, and then even less in some cases. So Mike, tourbillon watches, more accurate, true or false?
If you leave them in one position, then they're going to be more accurate. But the watch is never in one position. So the tourbillon is always rotating. Mm-hmm. So it's covering the 360 degrees every minute, unless the 30 seconds, you know, depending on what the tourbillon is. No, they're not more accurate. Actually, in I don't know if it was last year or 2 years ago, the JLC non-tourbillon actually won, you know, yeah, the timing.
But we've actually seen that since 2009, there is a modern chronometry trial. It's not quite the observatory shootouts involving hundreds of brands that we knew in the 19th and 20th centuries. But since 2009, the Horology Museum of Le Locle, Switzerland has overseen the Concours de Chronometry. And although JLC did win with a tourbillon the first year, for instance, their master tourbillon, their simple, almost industrially built tourbillon, beat the multi-axial gyro tourbillon. And in every edition since that first 2009 running of the competition, they do it every 2 years, Tissot with an ETA 2824 has been right up in the top two or three watches.
Yeah, it depends on how the watch is adjusted. We can make any watch run in chronometer specs. I pulled a delta of 0.5 today on a watch. And it's just, a delta is the split between the fastest and slowest rates and position. But again, the tourbillon, it was designed, when Breguet made the tourbillon, it was to compensate for gravity.
Imagine the pocket watch sitting in one position in the pocket, constant orientation, the tourbillon spins on its axis, and its axis is always in opposition to gravity. Now, on the wrist, Mike, the average...
We're all over the place. You know, so exactly. Even if the watch is compensating for positions, it doesn't matter because we're compensating for positions as well.
Yeah, the pocket watch and the tourbillon go together like a pig in excrement. But the bottom line is that you can regulate a tourbillon in the modern era to do extraordinary things. That JLC Master Tourbillon, a relatively simple watch based on the Autotractor automatic, a sub $50,000 steel watch, it averaged out to something like 47 seconds of deviation per year. So you can do extraordinary things. And in the years since, Grubel Forse has won the competition. I believe 1 year Louis Monet won with a tourbillon. Tourbillon have continued to excel, but only very carefully regulated, low-volume, specialized watches, or in the case of JLC, a computer-designed, largely machine-fabricated powerhouse from a company that had a reguleur, a specialist regulator, tinker with the thing before it went to market. Otherwise, Tissot with the 2824 getting the same results.
Yeah, it depends on how you're setting the watch up. And again, right now, tourbillons, they're beautiful to watch, they're beautiful to look at. It's a complication. It's very difficult to master, very difficult to build, so it is a complication. It's also a novelty.
Yeah, I'll also say this, they're fantastic to look at, but if you want to look at modern innovations in tourbillon technology that matter, look at the multi-axial tourbillon and also look at watches that use differentials, that not necessarily tourbillon, but something like the Roger Dubuis Couture with multiple escapements attached to each other by a differential, all at angular opposition such that they're always canceling each other out. That's not a tourbillon, but that's a valid system for evening out gravity-induced variation. The multi-axial tourbillon from the likes of Thomas Pressure, Gerard Perregaux, Jaeger-LeCoultre, Cabestan, and also finally, take a look at what Grubel Forse is doing, because they are using differential geared tourbillon, but also that 30 degree tourbillon angle, that's the average angle of a watch on the wrist,
right,
scientifically.
Exactly.
So
they are cool though.
They are really cool.